See the front page? Do you see it? Somewhere on there. So the first part of it is take this and write it in terms of tan. Okay, so first and foremost, things that I need to think about. I need to get it in terms of the word tangent. So what do I need to remember that makes tangent?
Sine over cosine,
right? So I need to divide by some form of cosine, right? But if you think about it for a moment, what's the highest level of cosine I got going on? That's the one I need to be concerned with. Because if I divide by plain cosine, I still got the word cosine left here. Do you agree with me?
Right.
Yes.
So how do you know like which Pythagorean identity to look at? Because you could either do sine squared or you could do cosine squared.
Right, right. I agree with you there, but go ahead. Yeah.
You want sine over cosine.
You do ultimately want sine over cosine tangent. Because it is tangent. Did that make sense? Because in a normal situation, if they're not asking you to get in terms of tangent, I would say, all right, start converting one into the other and try to combine like terms and do that sort of thing.
But
yes.
If you were to change the cosine squared into 1 minus sine squared, wouldn't you still have sine over cosine on the left side? Because you have to divide it by everything.
You would combine like terms and then you would divide everything by the word cosine. It may get you there. Because you still have the word cosine over there. Is that what you're asking?
Well, never mind.
I did it, but I feel like I did it wrong.
Well, we're going to try and see.
Okay.
So I think because you need sine over cosine, and you don't want just a plain cosine left,
divide
you have to divide
squared
by the highest power of cosine that you can find. Is everybody okay?
Right.
Right? Okay. So over here, the very left thing, sine squared over cosine squared, is
tangent squared theta.
Tangent squared, right? So I now know I have tan squared theta. Okay, now what? Yes.
Can you separate the cosine squared on the bottom to make two different fractions?
Sure. Okay. So how would that look? Let me do a little aside here. It would look like this. I would have 3 sine cosine over cosine times cosine.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then it'd be 3 tan, and then it'd be the cosine and tan.
Okay, so I see hands up, so 3 tan.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I was saying, like, you cancel out the cosine theta up there, and then that cancels one of the cosine thetas. You're still left with one of the denominators, so the sine over cosine becomes tangent.
Correct.
You wouldn't make that cosine over cosine just 1?
Yeah, correct. It does, because 1 times anything is whatever.
So
you separate them, you don't add them? Multiply.
Well, if you're thinking of it, like just look at it this way, I see one of the cosines can go away with one of the cosines.
Okay.
So what I'm left with is sine over cosine.
And then equals 4.
Right, it equals 4. Jake, you had your hand up?
Oh, yeah. How did you decide to like divide by cosine squared?
Okay, so I know ultimately it tells me my goal is to get tangent, the word tangent.
Right.
And the way the word tangent happens is if I have a sine over a cosine. So I don't want the word cosine left over at all. If I divided by cosine to the first, I would have 1 cosine left over here, and I don't want that. I want tangent. So the way to get rid of the word cosine is to divide by all the cosines, which is cosine squared.
And is that like the best one to get rid of first?
Correct, because you know you need to get sine over cosine.
Yeah.
Yes.
What if you had like sine squared theta over cosine theta or sine theta over cosine? Because you can't really have that, can you?
Right, it wouldn't happen. It would be left with a sine or a cosine on top, which is not tangent.
So in that case, you would want to look at your identities to try to convert it to something
correct
else.
Correct. You have every... And so this is kind of tough to teach because you have like different scenarios. It's kind of like a flow chart, you know? Can I factor it first and foremost? Yes or no? If yes, do it. Move on. If no, then where do I go? Can I pull something out? If yes or no, yes, do it. If not, what do I do next? I have to kind of have a little checklist in my mind of what exactly am I trying to get accomplished. And in this case, the word tangent has to be what comes up. So I know ultimately my goal is to have sine over cosine. Okay? So really it's hard to teach. You have to kind of gauge what you want and and what could be, what could I do to accomplish that? Yes. Question? No, you just do it. Okay, so now I see
trinomial.
I see trinomial, right? It screams, I'm a trinomial, you need to factor me, right? So I'm gonna pull it all to one side because we know we can't factor a trinomial unless it's set to zero. Keep that in mind, please. So once I start factoring, now this becomes an okay kind of problem. So we have tan theta, we have tan theta, we have the number 4 and 1, the positive, the negative is 0. So far so good?
Yeah.
And we're going to set both parts. Okay, so truly, how can it be written? Here it is, this is like done, right? So that's part I. Part II I'm doing now.
Okay.
Part II says now solve between 0 and 180. So to me, it just naturally flows into the next piece.
Yeah.
Okay? So, are we good?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to take both pieces and equal it to 0, set, solve for the word tangent. Okay? You're going to use your calculator to your best bet. Things I need to think about. Yes. You would invert, yeah, we'd inverse tan, right. So you would say here, theta is equal to inverse tan to the negative 1 of 1, and then theta is equal to tan to the negative 1 of negative 4. But in my brain, I'm thinking, where is tangent positive? What quadrants?
It's, the first and third.
Yeah, well, they're the same, right? So my answer for this guy is going to be here and here. Gonna keep that in mind. And where's my tangent? Negative.
And second and fourth.
So here and here. So potentially I could have four answers if they're not undefined, if it doesn't come up error. Oh, and it's between 0 and 180, so we can ignore those guys down there. Well, that's great. If it was 0 to 360, then we would potentially have 4. Good catch. Great catch. That's exciting. So, did we do this?
Mm-hmm.
That should be an easy one.
45.
Why do I think it should be easy? It's where your sine and cosine are the same, right? Because when you divide by the same thing, you get a number 1.
Yeah.
So 45 makes perfect sense. If this was 0 to 360, let's pretend for 2 seconds, if this was 0 to 360, where would the next answer be?
225.
Excellent. Okay, because you know it's 180 degrees away. All right, yes.
So how did you know it was 45 degrees?
Because you do the inverse tan of 1 on your calculator.
And then just 45.
Yeah.
And then, so you want to look at if it's negative or positive, and then see, so you're only concerned with those quadrants, and then only the numbers from those quadrants matter.
Right. Exactly right.
Yeah. It's 180
to
tan, right? Like,
180. Yeah, tan is pretty nice. It's 180.
Yeah.
Okay, now, what about this guy?
Negative
76. Negative what? 76. Negative 76 is located down here. We got issues, right? Because, I mean, in a good world, it's okay, but we're not between 0 and 180.
So you just mark it off?
So, but we actually
have...
Well,
you drop a imaginary line to the other quadrant.
Right, right. So we know negative 76 is down here. The other one has to be in this quadrant.
Right.
And then it goes here again, and then it goes here again, and then it goes here again, et cetera, forever. I could do that for fun. So from negative 76, how far do I have to be to get here? 180 degrees more, right? Yes. Okay, that's a good question. So negative 76, if I'm kind of thinking about it, this right here, this would be 60 degrees away. Would
mm-hmm.
you agree? So negative 76 is in here.
Mm-hmm.
Which is the closest line? This guy here, right? So the closest line is going to be this guy here. Everybody cool with that? Because it's going to be, you know, okay. So it's going to be how far away? So I say this is really 90 degrees from here. So what is it?
14.4.
Okay, so from here it's 14.4. away
mm-hmm.
from 90. And
wait,
so what's that? Okay, so what's 90 degrees minus 76 point-ish, whatever that was?
Because it's 76 point whatever it is from 360 and only 19.27.
Right, right.
Or 14.
Right. And so 14 from here, 90 plus that 14-ish is 104-ish. Okay, so what is the answer? 104.4. Thank you. Do we get it? Does that help?
And this is pretty much going to be every question on the test.
Listen, if you guys can do this, if you guys have a confident level in this, I guarantee that it'll be on, I'm going to say this now, and I'll be wrong. But I can guarantee this will be on the AICE exam at the end of the year. And I can guarantee for the last however many years, people have probably lost points because they would put negative 76 point whatever and be done and move on. And I did not do a good job. I'm gonna own it. I didn't do a good job explaining how do I get the other angle that makes it true. You know,
so those are your two angles. Mm-hmm.
And why was negative 76? First of all, it's not between 0 and 180, right? And we know between 0 and 180 is only just these two guys, these two places. Yes.
So is it typically when you're doing that, it's two angles, right? You've got one and then the reference angle, then the other one?
I'd like to say yes, but it just depends on what we're looking for. If they did 0 to 720, what if they did negative 90 to 90? What if they did negative 90 to 90? What would my two answers be? It would be 45, that would be okay,
mm-hmm.
and negative 76 point whatever that we got on our calculator. So what is really important with these questions is what is this parameter that we're looking at?
Do you think they'll ever do one like negative?
I've seen it. Okay, I have another one that I did with fourth or fifth period yesterday that I really would like to do again today. I cannot for the life of me remember which one it is, but it's a really tough solve. So I thought maybe we could go over it.
Are you doing it on that board?
I try to. Okay.
Do you think they'll do like 0 to 170 but all positive answers?
Say that again to me.
0 to 720, so two times around, but all
I don't think I've ever seen 0 to 720. 0 to 360, negative 90 to 90, 0 to 180. Just really, just look at it and then know. I think crossing fingers, I feel like you guys all have a comfort level now with where things could potentially fall and how you find it. Yes.
And so if you had tan 2 theta equals negative 4, is that the situation where you have to divide by 2? So even though like you might have like, you know, 460, you divide by 2 and see if it follows
fall
in there.
In our thing, yeah. So that causes an extra little step,
mm-hmm.
that we have to kind of be aware of. So what I would do is I would go to 225, knowing
mm-hmm.
that it's not true from 0 to 180, but when
mm-hmm.
I divide it by 2, it falls between 0 and 180.
Mm-hmm.
And then I would find my next one and divide it by 2 as well. So important that you keep, that's a good thought
mm-hmm.
process, yes.
And then for the test, is it between 0 and 360 and 0 and 180?
Yes, either or. Okay. All right, so this one that I'm going to do right now is October, November, 2009/12, number 5, and it's sine x plus cosine x, and then 1 minus sine x cosine x is really equal to sine cubed plus cosine cubed, and it wants me to solve this, okay, it wants me to solve that, equals 9 sine cubed from 0 to 360. Okay, you should have it in front of you, so, yes.
Then one is to solve this?
At the end, part II. Mm-hmm. So it's part I is show
they
this.
They want us to get eventually to 9 sine.
Right, they want me to take, you guys have your paper in front of you, right?
Yes, I don't have that.
Mm-hmm. Prove the identity sine.
So prove it's equal to 9 sine.
Okay, can we just write, instead of writing the parentheses, can't we just write the sine cube because mm-hmm. that's what we have to prove it is?
Right. We're going to do that. That's
and then
that's,
we'll use that instead of the big parentheses because it's already like...
But it's like that one thing where like you did like a of f of d where you did...
No derivative. This is just show this side equals this and now solve. And that's what your test will look like tomorrow. It'll be truly show that this side looks like this side and now use that new thing to solve.
Yeah.
So this problem I chose for a reason because it is one... difficulty level a little higher than most. So if I'm looking at this, remember my goal when I started teaching in this well back in the day? I said, what are my criteria? Where do I start?
You want to start the easiest.
It's easier to make something that's big, bad, ugly become smaller than something that's real small to try to expand it out to make it bigger.
Mm-hmm.
So it's easier to take this side and clean it up with natural algebra skills to try to make it look like this.
And don't touch that side.
Don't touch the other side. Yes.
So it's typically always the left side you want to make it look like the right. 95%
of the time. 99%
of the time,
yeah. Okay, so I'm going to foil this out, right?
Sine of x.
So I have sine of x.
Plus sine
well,
squared.
Minus
sine squared cosine.
Plus cosine of x.
Minus
sine
x cosine squared x.
Okay. Are we good so far?
Mm-hmm.
I foiled.
And then you combine no, you can't. Just
so, this is where fourth period, or fifth period, I can't remember which one, they were at a point where we're like, what do you do now, right?
Wait,
okay.
Is it like an identity?
No, it's not an identity.
But you know,
no,
you have sine plus cosine, so
but if you had sine squared plus cosine squared, you'd be okay with that. Because it's just sine, not so nice.
No, I mean, like, you
can
have it part like, what?
You can... Go ahead.
Cosine is 1 over sine. Or no.
No. Tangent is one over cosine, sine over cosine. Okay, so I'm going to give you my healthy hint, because I think this is one that I really want to kind of talk about. Did anybody have Coach Lusk?
No.
Nobody had the pleasure. You did? Freshman year. Factor by grouping. Is that something?
Yes.
Did he always talk about factor by grouping? It was like his favorite thing to teach. I know that. Factor by grouping. What that does is you take things that are in common.
That was my favorite thing to do.
So it's your favorite thing to do. That would be the technique I would use here. I would say, okay, so I'm looking at this, and I'm going to say, I have sine to the first here.
Yeah.
I have sine to the first here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to pull those together in order. So I'm going to do this. I have sine of x minus sine of x cosine squared. You'll see.
Same thing with the cosine.
And I'll do the same thing with the cosine. So I'm going to put plus cosine next because it's just nicer to have a positive. And then I'm going to put the one that has just the cosine.
Wait.
So I just rearrange the order. Commutative property of addition tells me I can do that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, if you notice here, these first two things
have
a sign in common.
So you can take
out the sign.
And then these two guys,
mm-hmm.
right?
And then you have two that are outside parentheses together, one, and then the other
so,
should be the same.
Just like Coach Lust told you every day when you went to class, you pull out the sine, you're left with 1 minus cosine squared.
Which is also...
You pull out the cosine. I won't tell them.
And those two, and then 1 minus cosine squared equals sine squared,
yeah.
And 1 minus sine squared equals cosine squared.
Right.
And then you combine them.
You got what you need, yes.
But you recommend this is the best way to do this?
This is probably your best way to do it.
Like any, I mean, there are probably other ways, but... they're difficult.
Honestly, I'm not certain which way you would do it. If you got to this spot, you can't add unlike terms. They have to be like terms.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in my brain, I'm going through things that potentially could make this thing work.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to be able to kind of combine like terms. Okay, so what I could possibly do is I could possibly take sine squared and make it 1 minus cosine squared for now and distribute that through, make cosine squared be 1 minus sine squared, and then try to combine like terms, see if that helps. Maybe that's a route. Okay. For the sake of time, you know, this would be our best bet. So now I have the word sine here, and you guys all get as excited as I do. You see Pythagorean identity. 1 minus cosine squared is sine squared. And then this is cosine, and 1 minus sine squared is cosine squared.
And you can just multiply them and you have.
And you have what you're looking for. So, I have sine to the third plus cosine to the third, which is, yeah, exactly what I need. I know, I like that. It's exciting to me.
And then we have to make that look like 9 sine.
So that's the deal. So, and I chose this particular problem for a reason. Not because, oh my gosh, I would never think of this, you know? Whatever, it's 1 point, maybe two. But the next part would be the part that I would hope that we could kind of pull together. So I know that it tells me to solve that. I know what we just found is what we're going to utilize. So that makes sense. And like Lance said in the very beginning, shouldn't you just write it like that now? So sine cubed plus cosine cubed equals 9 sine cubed. You good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I see sines and cosines. I see that they're all with the same exponential power. I don't see that I have a Pythagorean identity because it's cubed. So
cube
what should I think of? I can't cube root everything because they're individuals. Yes?
You want to get sine on one side, cosine on the other, and then you can divide by cosine and tangent.
Okay, so if I take and bring that over, I hopefully see sines and cosines, right? And I know when sines and cosines are the only thing available and they're not squared Pythagorean identities, just like they were to the first power, I should try to think tangent, yes.
So you're going to divide by cosine cubed x on both sides, and then you're going to have it equal to 0, and then you're going to solve
not
for
0.
1.
So over here, what is that?
It cancels out.
It becomes what?
1.
Oh,
1. And that's 8, and then the word tangent. Now what?
Divide
by 8, yeah? So 1/8 equals tan cubed. Now, the suggestion earlier was cube root everything. Now I can cube root everything. Yes.
Why is
this 8? Well, I have one of these, and I subtract one from there. So what is the cube root of 1/8?
1/2.
1/2.
Okay, so 1/2 is tan x.
And then you can look.
Say it again. Okay, good question, because that's a
trick. Cube is
a, cube is not, right? But what would be?
Square.
Good.
And,
or the fourth.
Any even.
Right. Okay, so, and a lot of people, Jake, I'm glad you talked about that. A lot of people would go, if this was the pretend, if this was negative 1/8 equals tan cubed, would that be okay to take the cube root of it?
Uh-huh.
Because it's cubic. I can take the cube root of a negative. So a lot of people go, oh, I can't take a cube root because it's negative. That's not true. So square root, if I take the square root of both sides, I have plus and minus. If I take the cube root of both sides, I just have whatever value of that sine it is.
Good.
Is that good? Okay, so tangent is positive, 1/2, right? Tangent is positive. Tangent is positive where?
One.
This guy and that guy, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So those are where my two answers will be. You're on it. Okay, and my answers are gonna fall between 0 and 360. So that's important for me to know. So tangent equals 1/2. So what in this case is x?
26.6.
You said 26.6, thank you. So you got that by using your calculator. I will not have extra calculators available. I don't know where my gray one walked away. The white one's still here, but who knows if it'll be here at the end of the day. So just make sure you bring your calculators with you, it's important. Okay, so you have tangent equals 1/2, so it's x equals 26.6, and where is its corresponding angle? What do I do to get for tangent? Add 180. 180 plus that was
2. So you get the tangent at 1/2?
Yes.
Why don't you do
arctan? Arctan.
But I didn't get that.
Tan to the negative 1 of 1/2. Put parentheses around the 1/2 and try it again. So what do you get? 2. What'd you get here?
206.6.
Point. And so are those the only two answers? Yes. Yes.
So then you have 206.6, which is in between 180 and 210, right? It falls in there.
And the 26 would have been here, so there.
And then the, why'd you get the 26?
Oh,
you.
We don't have to do the negative.
You didn't have to do negative because it's positive already, right?
Okay. So then you just have those two answers.
Because it's
if you add 180, then it's 186.
Too big.
Matt,
did you get there?
Yeah.
Okay. Are we good? Are we feeling it for tomorrow?
Damn.
Somewhat? Pick one to do and try, and we'll see if we get the right answer.
We're going to do a test tomorrow. You're not going to be here.
Yeah.
That's, she's giving us how many tests that we've not been here.
I know you are.
Okay, so it says 3 tan theta equals 2 cosine can be expressed as this. Okay? So it wants me to take this and make it look like that. So this. Do you agree?
Yeah.
I got that far. Okay. And then I don't want fractions.
What?
So I'm going to bring that over there. Then.
Oh, you multiply it. We'll see what you do.
Yeah.
The box.
What is
your
wait.
What did I do? Yeah, we're making that become that. You see it now? And then. Right?
Mm-hmm.
We're making that become that.
Yeah, I saw that. It's just like a lot.
So then.
Think to one side.
Bring it all to one side, that's right.
Is that possible?
Then it, now this part I is solve between 0 and 1. 180, 360.
Good question.
360. So you would factor?
No.
I teach bell to bell because they love my voice. Somebody does.
Yeah.
Right? They can't get enough of it. And it's from 0 to 360? I totally forgot already.
Yeah, 360.
Right?
Yes. So then you do.
So you do inverse sine of 1/2
to get that answer. And you do inverse sine of -2 to get that answer.
What happens here?
It doesn't exist.
Error, right? That thing.
Oh, yeah.
You cross it out.
So that just goes away?
Yeah.
Watch, I'm going to write my calculus.
Yeah, just
between
0 and 1. Like if sine is more than 1, is it?
Okay, so now you're getting into something a little different. The inverse tan.
Wait.
Do you notice everything we've done with inverse tan has been negative, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
So your inverse tan answer. I don't even want to confuse people.
Don't say it.
Just be quiet. Yeah. Yeah.
So
I'm not going to speak
for this
either.
So answer is only one answer, which is 30.
Okay, so what
or
is
you
it?
Keep going.
Well,
sine of 1/2, which is
so it's 30, right?
Yeah.
So sine is 1/2 at 30, but it's for between 0 and 360.
So you do again.
Yeah, you have to figure out where else is it positive 1/2.
150.
Right here.
115 is it?
Don't touch my stuff.
30 and 150.
So if you look at 30, you only get 0.3.
You won't get any.
Won't get any.
What? That's what I told you guys. I think that's what was happening in the past.
Can we get like capital?
Oh,
no. I go by the mark schemes. So.
Whoa.
And we really have really emphasized the fact that there potentially are more than one answer.
So are they worth a lot of points? Or?
They're worth one answer point.
Wait, how do you get one?
No, they're just worth 1 point.
But still, one is
two out of three.
So
one is good.
Yeah.
How do you get 150?
Okay, so where is sine positive 1/2 between 0 and 360? So it's here.
Oh, because the other one's 1/2.
Here.
Oh, I forgot that 1/2.
You forgot that thing. Yeah, it's on there.
How many points is it worth?
Well, that'd be like.
Okay, but what if it's not on there? How far is it? It's 30 degrees away from this reference line, so therefore it's 30 degrees from that reference line.
What? Getting this to equal this is equal to Pythagoras.
Well, this one is 3, but
sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1.
That's it.
No, we have this on the sheet.
You have that on the sheet. But then you have to be able to subtract sine squared or subtract cosine squared and recognize it. Like 1 minus sine squared.
So we can use our reference.
Yes. Okay.
on any test.
So we can use that and the
unit circle.
We can use our unit circle.
Yeah.
And you give the approval for my unit circle.
I like it.
And then
if people want to print it out, they can.